Yo, so in my last video, I was fine-tuning the outer threshold, but I didn't fully explain it in the video. I wanted to just put it in the comment section because putting it in text is easier to follow than if I was just to sit here and talk through it. I'm gonna try and talk through it for people who aren't able to view the comment section, like for people who are viewing YouTube on their consoles. So what I did before I got to the position I was just at was I was playing at 9 response curve. I was doing through by just pressing left and right on the D-pad, I got to 9 response curve. I need to play at 9 response curve because if I play at 8 response curve, I'm drifting too much for me to snipe people if the character model is too small. In fact, I was drifting so much that I was struggling to shoot low bolts that were pretty big on my screen. So I need to play at 9 response curve, and the dead zone of my controller is 2%. While I was playing at 9 response curve, I went through all of the 2% dead zones available to me. There's two 2% that turn into 4s, and there's 3 2% that turn into 5s. The current 2% that I'm at, everything behind the 8 and everything behind it moves, then 7 and everything but 8 moves. I call this back half, front half. I did this for every 2% dead zone available to me. I went. Is this different? This is still back half, front half. If I go here, this is a 2 that turns into a 5. At this position, 5 and 9 or something like that is moving. I don't know what's going on. Anyways, the acceleration pattern that I'm looking for is not available to me at default 9 and the 2% dead zones. Every pattern is close to what I want, but none of them are quite right. There are patterns where 2 through 6 is the same and it feels slow. There are patterns where 2 through 7 is the same and it feels slow. There are patterns where 2 through 4 is the same and it feels fast. There is a pattern where 2 and 3 is the same and it feels fast. So then I went from every 2% dead zone and went point by point through the 9 response curve. And in order for it to not be in a completely unbelievably daunting task, like just like what am I doing here? There's a trick to it. Whatever is moving initially will always be greater than or equal to whatever isn't moving. So as I go up this and I pay attention to the pattern, this is still, it looks like it's still back half, front half, but once I get to this position, the third block is moving. At default 9, the third block isn't moving once I get to this position. So this pattern looks similar to back half front half, but it's different than back half front half. I'm just looking for the breakpoints I want. I want 2 to be more than 1, I want 6 to be more than 5. So as I go up to 9, I'm just paying attention to what is moving and what isn't moving. I'm trying to click with some of the white dot inside of the orange bar so that I feel as though I'm going up 0.1 and not skipping any position. So now 3 is more than 2. Three is moving closer to 2. Stuff behind it, I don't know, stuff isn't moving. 3 is always closer to 2. 3 is always closer to 2, so I don't even need to concern myself with this pattern. I go to the next response curve, the next 9. Now 2 is closer to 1, and probably 9 is more than 8. I don't know what's going on. Then everything else moves. I need 6 to be more than 5. 1, 2, 5. 5 is more than 6. 7 is more than 6, which means they're always going to be more. I'm gonna just go up. They're equal now. They move together, together, together. 6 is not more than 5, so I can just move on to the next pattern. All I'm doing is paying attention to where the breakpoints are. I know where I want things to be more than other things, so as I'm going up this, I'm just paying attention to those positions. I did this for every 2% dead zone. I don't know. I hope this makes sense to people who can't access the comment section, because I realized after I uploaded my last video that if somebody couldn't access the comment section, they couldn't fully understand what I was doing here. I hope it made sense. The reason I wanted to do it in the comment section was because saying all this just sounds very confusing to me, and I'm the one saying it. Like, I know what I'm saying and it sounds confusing. And I'm trying to say it as simply as I possibly can. Peace.